Nucleic acids. One more type of biomolecules are nucleic acids. It was observed that the characteristics are transferred from one generation to another generation. Generally, while we are going to observe ancestors, so some characters are similar from our parent generation to our generation and our generation to next daughter generations or next generations. So how it takes place? How the characteristics of one generation transferred to another generation? Here, all this takes place due to nucleus present in cell. Every living organism cell at its center consists of nucleus. Here, actually, this nucleus is having genes. These are made up of chromosomes. Here, the entire responsibility to transfer characters from one generation to another generation observed due to presence of chromosomes. What are the chromosomes? Are chromosomes are having two chemical substances, made up of two chemical substances named as proteins and nucleotides, or we can consider directly it as nucleic acids. Proteins and nucleic acids. In human beings, two types of nucleic acids are present in human beings. They are DNA and second one is RNA. The two types of nucleic acids are DNA and RNA. Deoxyribonucleic acid, whereas it is ribonucleic acid. So DNA, RNA. So deoxyribonucleic acid is called as DNA, ribonucleic acid is called as RNA. So these two types of nucleic acids are present in animal body, especially in human body. Here, DNA, due to presence of DNA and RNA, they are useful to transport characteristics from one generation to another generation, as well as these two nucleic acids are involved in protein synthesis. Here, let us have further. These DNA and RNA is made up of nitrogen base pairs, comma, carbohydrate units, and phosphate linkage. So let us have deeply. In deoxyribonucleic acid and ribonucleic acid, which will be considered as nucleic acids, two types of nitrogen base pairs present. They are, first one, purines, and second one, pyrimidines. The two types of nitrogen bases present in DNA and RNA are purines and pyrimidines. The general structure of purines will have, the geometry of purines will be represented as N, N, H. So this is the general structure of purines, whereas the general structure of pyrimidines are these pyrimidine bases and purine bases present in DNA and RNA, which are considered as nucleic acids. Here in DNA and RNA, further two types of purine bases are present. They are, first one, adenine, second one, guanine. So in DNA and RNA, our nucleic acids are having two types of nitrogen bases, purine bases and pyrimidine bases. Further, two types of purine bases are present. They are DNA and RNA. Here, three types of pyrimidine bases are present. They are, one, cytosine. Number two, thymine. Number three, uracil. Here, two types of purine bases, three types of pyrimidine bases generally found to exist in nucleic acids. That too, in DNA, DNA is made up of adenine, guanine as purine bases, cytosine, thymine as pyrimidine bases. These are the purine bases present in DNA and pyrimidine bases present in DNA. Similarly, but in RNA, adenine, guanine, purine bases, cytosine, uracil, pyrimidine bases present.